And welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, if you always thought shacking up was a bad idea, well, you may be living in the past. A recent government study shows that more people are choosing to live with their significant other before marriage, and more of those relationships are lasting longer. Nearly half of the women surveyed moved in without a ring on it. Go ahead, dance, Michaela. Nice. Oh, if you could only see the moves. About 40% of those relationships turned into marriages after 3 years, but about 32% just kept on cohabitating. And you know what that means.
Living together.
Right. There you go. No, my moves aren't as good. What do you think about this?
Well, first I want to ask you, just because you are married.
Yes.
Did you live together prior to?
No, I didn't. I didn't. And you know what it was? For me, it was my don't be mad when I say this, but it was my Catholic guilt.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say it was your cat.
No. I don't have a cat.
I was like, can't you want to live with a cat?
I don't have a cat.
You kind of paused there? Just saying.
Maybe if I had a cat, maybe that would have stopped.
It was your Catholic guilt.
It was my Catholic. I just couldn't do it. I mean, you know, it just wasn't for me.
Mm-hmm.
It just wasn't for me.
But you were together for a while.
We were together for a couple of years beforehand. I mean,
okay.
If you don't know by then, I don't think you're ever gonna figure it out.
That is kind of true. And also, I feel like when you get married, you want something new and something fresh.
Sure.
So maybe moving in together is fun. For me, I think I would want to live with the person though before, because let's face it, if you go away with someone, or even if it's just for one overnight, you see.
It's a whole other world.
You're brushing your teeth in front of each other, and you just see like a lot of tendencies that you wouldn't normally with. You're just going out to dinner.
You're right. It's those surprising things where you go. You brush your teeth too?
Right. You're kind of messy, or these are your tendencies.
Right.
So I think maybe just living together, even if it's just for a brief time.
Right.
It's still a good idea. Someone who does not agree with that though.
Right.
Is Megan.
Is our own Megan.
She's in a house by herself right now. Megan?
In the convention
center. Hey, guys. I've been able to hear a little bit of what you were talking about, and saw Michaela do a little dance. I've done the whole cohabitating thing, and I would never do it again. I'm loving this living alone thing. But also, I wasn't in the mindset of thinking about all the challenges and the great things about marriage that would come after that. And while I was always in that idea of, I really want to live together with somebody before marriage, before making it legal, I would never do it again, just because I think that you need to really know what's going to be the next step. So that would be my thing.
Maybe moving in together, like while you're engaged, maybe that would be good, because you're kind of on a good path.
Yes. You have to have these conversations.
You're hoping there's an end to all of it. Yeah.
Exactly. All right. Thank you, Megan, for weighing in on that.
In that house all by yourself?
Some other people that are weighing in on that this morning is, of course, our Facebook friends.
Yeah, they are.
Amanda Hesford-Couture thinks it's a good idea to live together, saying, I lived with my husband before we got married. Best decision ever. We figured out each other's strange quirks prior to marriage. Happily married 5 years and counting. Congratulations to you. Dean Harrington believes it should be left up to the couple. He says, to each his or her own, but marriage is special, and one of its planks should be the commitment of living together. All right.
Okay.
Maria Sudo agrees with Dean, saying, quote, didn't live with my husband before we got married. Been married 12 years. To each his own, do what's right for you.
Whatever works for you.
Apparently that was right for her though.
Mm-hmm.
And Sloppy Joe thinks cohabitation is good. She says, better to find out if you can happily live together before you make it legal. I don't like the old term shacking up. It's negative and judgmental, and I wish older people would just stop using it. Perhaps they wish they had done it themselves.
Aha.
Interesting take.